What is Hyperlocal Marketplace Delivery System? A Hyperlocal Marketplace Delivery System refers to the platform that helps in the delivery of the various goods and services within the limited geographical area. In a Hyperlocal Marketplace Delivery System, the consumer or the customer can browse and order various goods and services from the website and the apps. The system aggregates offerings from local businesses such as grocery stores, restaurants, pharmacies, and other retailers to making them easily accessible for the customer. The Hyperlocal system is needed. So hi everyone, my name is Vashu, and to build a Hyperlocal Marketplace Delivery System on Shopify, we are going to discuss Hyperlocal Marketplace Feature App for the Multimedia Marketplace app for Shopify by Webkul. But before proceeding further, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for more informative videos. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sale of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webkul.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog section, from where you can check the features, configuration, and get to know functionality of the extension as well. Now let's move back to our video. So let's check the configuration part, how to set up the Hyperlocal Marketplace feature app in your Shopify store. So guys, this is our Multimedia Marketplace app dashboard. Okay, first you need to enable the Hyperlocal Marketplace app feature app from the feature app section. You just need to go to the three dots and then feature app and search for the Hyperlocal. So here's the Hyperlocal Marketplace feature app. Pricing is about $20 per month. And as you can see, it is currently active on my store. So we can directly go to the configuration part from the configuration section. Then need to search for the Hyperlocal configuration. So here's the Hyperlocal configuration. Okay. So as you can see, the hero section and the tagline. You can enter the tagline 1, tagline 2 here as per your need or as per your requirement. And you can change the label at search placeholder. These are the placeholder. Enter your delivery location. Button text for searching result. Find food. You can edit them. And here you can upload the banner or the background banner image from here. Upload image section. Then the nearby service sections here are the labels. You can check. Or modify as per your requirement. Now let's check the other. So here is this Shopify theme for Hyperlocal. As we can see, there are two themes available right now. So you can select as per your need. The next one is the Google Map access token, and to get the access token you can click here, know how to generate the access token, and even I am adding the steps in the description section for the same. The next one is the instruction. This is a user guide for the Hyperlocal Marketplace feature app, so you will redirect to the user guide of the same. Okay, so the next one is the seller configuration for the Hyperlocal Hyperlocal global selling. Okay, so once you enable this, okay, your seller can be able to sell globally from their panel. They can manage, I mean, there will be the option if they want to sell globally or not. The next one is the select listing type. You want to show the seller listing on the search page, and if you select the seller listing, then you can select if you want to redirect the customer to the seller listing page from here or not. And if you select the product listing, then the product listing will be visible on the search page. So this is all about the Hyperlocal Marketplace configuration. Let's check how the seller can add their location and how the admin can add the seller location on their behalf. So let's check from the admin side. First, you need to go to the seller listing here. And as you can see, there is a seller, Ron Oproy, and let's check for this. So on the seller edit page, you will get a configuration of the hyperlocal. The very first one is the global selling, as admin enable this from their panel. That is why it is visible here. The next one is the location. Here the seller can add the location. I mean, this admin can add the location on behalf of the seller, like here. And maximum delivery distance. Here the distance you can enter on where you can deliver the product within the area, and click on the add location. Now let's check from the seller side, from the seller panel, how they can add their location. So this is the seller panel, guys, and for that we need to go to the profile section, then my account, and the pop-up will be there. Okay, here we need to enter the address. You scroll down to zoom the map. You can enter the location as well, and here you can enter the distance, just like a within a 10 km, and click on the add location. Seller location has been updated successfully. Okay, and if the seller want to sell the globally, here is the option. They can select from here. Okay, but no. So guys, this is all about the configuration part. Now let's check the front end section, that how the customer can check for the nearby sellers and the seller's product. So guys, this is the front end of the site. So here the customer need to enter the location, enter your delivery location here, and then click on the find food. But here I am using the current location, my current location. So using the current location, so here I will get the nearby products in the list, and as a customer I can select this from here and continue for the purchase. And if I need to update the location, then from here I can simply click here and I can enter the location here. So let's enter the new location. I'm just adding my pin code here. I'm searching for the product. As you can see, the product listing has been appeared for the customer. So guys, this is all about the Hyperlocal Marketplace feature app, and if you still have any further query, you can mail us on support@webkul.com. Also, you can create a ticket on webkul.uvdesk.com. If you like our video, do give us thumbs up, and also mention your valuable feedback in the comment section. Thank you so much. See you in the next video.